Hi guys, Nick Jennison from Guitar Interactive. Today, we're taking a look at the FT341 from our friends at Takamine. Now, this is a maple and spruce dreadnought that is strictly limited to 300 units worldwide. It's a really gorgeous example of Takamine's full-throated, big, full-bodied dreadnoughts, but with the addition of a maple back and sides, which adds sparkle and high-end kind of zing and life to the tone. We're going to take another quick listen to this guitar before we get too deep into the specifications. In the intro, you heard us miking this guitar with a large diaphragm condenser. We're going to keep that same miking configuration, but instead of playing lines with a thick pick, we're going to switch to some more dynamic finger style. Then we'll come back and talk more about the spec. So now we've heard this guitar played with a pick and with fingers, we will do a few more examples as well. Let's take a look at the specifications, starting as we always do at the headstock. So starting at the headstock, we have Takamine's iconic headstock shape. Everything is pretty much as you'd expect from a Takamine dreadnought on here, so they haven't changed the recipe too much. And that's a good thing, because Tak dreadnoughts are absolutely wonderful, as I'm sure you've heard in those two playing examples. But it is presented in this really elegant gloss black that is unfortunately picking up all of my fingerprints, but even still, it looks absolutely fabulous. We're gonna take a look at the back real quick where we can see the tuners. We have three-side, Takamine branded tuners, very solid, nice big overloid buttons, we like that a lot. On the back of the neck, again, we have this gloss black finish, feels really nice under the hand, and of course, looks very elegant too. And the neck profile is what you'd expect, again, from a Takamine dreadnought. It's fairly full, quite U-shaped, it's a good handle, but it's not absolutely massive, it's not like playing a Dobro or anything, but it is a good solid handle if you wanna get your thumb around and really wrestle with this guitar. But again, not intimidatingly large for players who maybe have smaller hands, let's say. So let's flip it back over, take a look at the fretboard. The neck is mahogany, by the way. Fretboard is rosewood. We have medium profile frets, which is code for very small frets, but that's kind of what you want in a guitar like this, because tall frets, they're just gonna kind of encourage us to press a little too hard and maybe bend the guitar out of tune. Now the playing action is actually very comfortable on this guitar, and some dreadnoughts do tend to come with, let's call it a more robust action that doesn't really kind of lend itself to being played up here in the dusty end. That is absolutely not the case here. This guitar is very comfortable throughout. It is a stitch of work thanks to the heavy strings that come as standard, but again, you could always swap those out if you like a lighter playing feel. We also have this lovely white binding, which really does offset the black finish in a really attractive way. It's a really classic look, that white on black. Very, very cool indeed. If we turn our attention down here, by the way, to the shoulder of the guitar, what we've got on this end is Takamine's retro-inspired CTF2N preamp system. Now, I'm not a huge fan of full-featured preamps on the body of the guitar, but I feel like this is a nice addition because it has that kind of classic Tak plugged-in sound, but also doesn't have quite so many options that allow you to tie yourself in knots. We have sliders for low and high, another for volume, and we have this notch control, which goes all the way from zero, i.e. the notch is off, through to the very low bass frequencies for defeating feedback, all the way through to those classic mid-notches that'll take us all the way up to 5K. Now, we also have a button to switch between a minus 6 dB notch and a minus 12 dB notch. And of course, if you want no notch at all, you can always just set that to zero. Now the tuner is very interesting because we have three modes of operation here. We have off, we also have the tuner on but not muted, but if we tap that a second time, this light is gonna flash to let us know that the output is muted. So if you want to tune in real time, let's say you're playing and you don't wanna stop, but maybe your G string's a little bit out, you can tap that tuner once, that light will remain solid, and you can very quickly and surreptitiously check your tuning without muting the output. Then it's a quick double tap to get back to the non-tuner mode if you want, or if you want to tune silently, double tap, that light's gonna flash and let you know that you're in silent tuning mode, which is kind of the more common way of doing things. But it's nice to have that option. We like that a lot. So anyway, moving away from this onto the body real quick, we have the same gloss black finish all the way through this with the white binding. Very, very attractive. Unfortunately, again, very conducive to fingerprints. And this guitar is so playable that I've been playing it a whole lot. So it's picked up a lot of my finger marks on the body. But you'll have to excuse me on that. Now, it is a solid spruce top, which is what you'd expect from a typical dreadnought of this type. All the mahogany models also exist. That spruce dreadnought thing is, it's pretty special. It's a classic for a reason. But what's interesting here is rather than the classic pairings of spruce and mahogany or spruce and rosewood, here we have spruce over maple and maple. I'll show you the back real quick. You can't really see terribly clearly because it's finished in gloss black. Again, more of my hair and finger marks on there, but even still, that is a maple back and maple sides, which make for a very bright and very projecting guitar with a real rich low end that comes from the sheer size of the body. It's a pretty big guitar. So again, lots of rich projection there, but the brightness that we get from the maple spruce combo is really evocative, especially for songwriter style strumming. To that end, we're gonna grab a thinner pick, we'll detune the low string to D, and we'll try some heavy handed strums and see just how well this guitar breathes fire with those big open chords. Let's take a listen to that now. So while this guitar certainly performs really, really well, especially for such a big dreadnought when you play it with single notes or with delicate fingerstyle, I think it's really most at home with those big songwriter strumming passages. And again, that's where Takamine dreadnoughts made their reputation, in my opinion, at least in their heyday, with all those classic singer-songwriter types laying down big fat slabs of chord. But we also have that brightness from the maple and the spruce, which is gonna mean this is gonna sit really well in a dense mix too, if you just want that sparkly high-end pick attack sound, that's gonna be available for you as well. Now, one of the domains where Takamine's really excel is in the live domain, and to that end, we have, again, that retro-inspired CTF2N preamp. Let's take a listen to it. We're gonna begin by doing a quick forensic tour of all the features. We'll start by turning the sliders for the highs and lows up and down. We'll explore the notch, we'll explore what the tuner does, and then we'll do an example of something a little more musical. But first, let's just examine how each of these features sounds at various points in its travel.
Thank you.
So there you go, guys. That's been a look at the Takamine FT341. It is strictly limited in this gloss black to 300 units worldwide. So if you want one, you're gonna have to move fast. And I feel like you probably do want one. It has a really fantastic authoritative strum, real great extended high end and upper mid range presence, and a bit of a natural scoop in the low mids that lends itself really well to sitting in a rock mix, but also sounds absolutely massive on its own. It's very comfortable to play and handle single notes really well. It also takes to more delicate fingerstyle passages in a way that you wouldn't expect from this type of guitar. It handles that with a lot more grace than some of the dreadnoughts out there. But again, it's really, for my mileage anyway, it's really kind of most at home with those big, rich, thick, strummy chords. I think that's really where this guitar excels, although it's also absolutely excellent plugged in, as I'm sure you heard. Once again, this is the Takamine FT341. My name is Nick Jennison from Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.